Dear audiences, welcome to our GRH Retreat House Real Life Stories Radio. We are honored to give you our sincere greetings in the love of Jesus Christ, as well as Mother of Perpetual Help. May the love and peace of the Holy Trinity be with you and with your family. This program will be guided by Father Chung Quynh Lu Ngoc, a Redemptorist in Hanoi and the members of GRH Retreat House. This radio is broadcasted with the purpose of sharing our experiences, discoveries, confirmation about problems relating to mental and spiritual illness, vocational discernments, religious and married life, and the ways that God has been leading us. This will be continuously broadcasted on YouTube's channel with the name GRH Real Life Stories. New stories will be updated continuously on radio and website svcongiao.net at 9 p.m. on Sundays. We hope that it can bring you into new perspectives, new hope, new directions, and the saving growth about human mysteries, illness, sorrows, and healings. Highlighting that these stories can be really useful for those people who are suffering from similar problems that other people have already experienced and been healed. Dear audiences, today we would like to send you the story of a catechuman. She was rescued in a strange way, so we saved her in this hard time. And to be said, what does she need to do? These questions will be answered right here. We are inviting you to listen to the story with the title, Who Saved Me? Through the reading voice of Ian.
I'm a catechumen. I was born and grew up in Taibing land. I have been married for 14 years. From the beginning, I didn't know anything about God, just followed without belief. When we intended to move towards marriage life, both families not only disagreed, but also vehemently opposed. Not a long time after wedding, my husband went to work far away to support family. I stayed home with my parents-in-law. Because they hadn't been fond of me before, they used many reasons to scold and curse me. Father-in-law cut off electricity every night, so there was always lighters or candles in my room. My husband went to work far away, so I was very lonely, sad, and depressed for living in the family life. My parents-in-law scold me all day long and treated me badly. When I was about to give birth, I asked them to let me go to my mother's home in order to give birth there, but they didn't allow. I obeyed on surface, but suddenly packed up belongings and determined that midnight to go back my home. That night was very cold. I was alone on the second floor without electricity. The room was dark. I was about to take my luggage away. Suddenly, there was a light shining on the room that made the room brighten. I thought it was due to the moonlight. I opened the window to check, but it was still as dark as ink. I looked up at the altar of the Lord. I saw the clear blue light and the cross print on the wall over the room. At that moment, I knelt down and made a sign of cross and prayed. I only knew 12 sutras. I read and repeated those. I was amazed and overjoyed to see this strange mystery on my own eyes. And since that moment, I had a strong faith in God. At that time, I just thought that I would entrust myself to God. and promised my heart to believe in him. And I immediately gave up the idea of giving birth in my mother's home. This was the first time I have been shown by God the power of his intervention. As the time went by, our family and children were fine. My parents-in-law didn't treat me like the way they did before. Marriage life was smooth and happy. Suddenly, one day, I got a pretty high fever. I felt very uncomfortable. I went to the doctor and he said there were tumors in me, but I didn't know whether it was benign or malignant. I returned home, waiting for the result in anxiety and fear. Because my daughter was only 3 years old, if I got sick, who would take care of her? Those anxious thoughts kept surrounding in my mind. But I could only entrust to God, pray to Him and Mother Mary. Then the darkest day of my life came. I was dumbfounded when I heard the doctor say, "The tumors you brought in was malignant." I was quietly, sadly returned home. I didn't dare to tell anyone. But the only thing I felt strange was that when I got home, parents, husbands encouraged me that it's okay, entrust yourself to God and ask Him to heal you. Those words helped me to have more motivation and spirit to fight this evil disease. I and my family found all kinds of herbal medicines to prevent the spread of the tumors because they grew a lot as quickly as octopus legs. My husband and I spent a lot of money to brought all kinds of mushrooms, but the condition still got worse. The disease got extremely serious. I was almost close to death. I knew I was going to die. I cried every night and confided to God alone. I prayed and begged Him, "Please allow me to live. Because my child is too small, may you just let me live in this world. Even if my life has so much suffering, I will bear it." I kept saying to God like that. I muttered to myself and pleaded earnestly. Every night, I repeated that plea. Then one day, I sat on the bed preparing to pray. When I was praying, I saw the rosary glowing in front of my sleeping pillow. When I stopped reading the prayer, the light turned off, and I continued reading. The rosary chain continued to grow, but this light even stronger and clearer than the beginning. I cried, crying like pouring rain, to thank God and Mother Mary, because I was convinced that God and Mother heard my prayer. I talked to my husband about what happened. My husband and I were more confident in the healing of God. Besides, my husband also asked for a prayer and asked for a ceremony for me. I felt something in my body. The pain seemed to reduce in half. The body was healthier. The tumors were also significantly reduced. The legs, like octopus legs, also gradually receded. Unexpectedly, I decided to go to the hospital to test again. After the test, the doctor said I had to wait for 2 hours before I could get the results. While waiting for it, I was very scared. In my mind, I kept asking, "My God, please manage the situation from malignant to benign." I always begging, then got the result. The doctor said the tumor would be benign. My family and I were happy and hugged each other in joy. The doctor told me to do surgery right away because he was afraid of complication. So I went to the operating table, operated successfully and safely. Great! God saved me once again. And at that time, I realized the meaning of the word of God. For man, it is impossible, but for God, everything is possible. I have never felt that happy before. Increasingly, I trust and entrust myself to Him. Through all the painful, difficult events and the seemingly insurmountable challenges, God feels His blessing down my life. I thank God for showing me the value of suffering and always responds to my earnest request. And more than that, He gave me the gift that I never thought of. The grace I received was to recognize God as true God and to believe in Him, to rely on Him, and to love Him. At the most difficult times, I ran toward God and He supported me. At the most dangerous moment, He saved me from escaping. I want to share my experience about the powerful and loving God that a catechumen like me has felt with other people. And I believe, for God, nothing is impossible, and His love for me is above all.
Thank you for listening to the Radio Chirat Retreat House Real Life Stories. We wish this heart sharing will be useful for you, and it's possible that someone in the same situation will also have a chance for being healed. Dear friends, if you feel this story gives you something interesting or useful, please click the register button to update the next podcast. If there is any suggestion or comment for our program, please send us via email nhatinatamgrieradio@gmail.com. Wish you all a new week full of joy and peace of Jesus Christ. Thank you so much and see you again on the next program.